I'm the coach. You're locked into the NFL on EA Sports. Up next, we'll see Jared Goff and the NFC champion Los Angeles Rams as they'll square off against Tom Brady and the Super Bowl champion New England Patriots. With that, let's head on up to Foxborough. Standing by with the call at Gillette Stadium, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
From the area known as Patriot Place, EA Sports set for football at Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. All the success in New England over the last few decades, and this crowd has never been more enthusiastic. A moment ago, the Pats emerged from their locker room. They are set as they'll square off with the Los Angeles Rams. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. This, of course, a big win, CD. Rematch of Super Bowl 53, and I'm not usually one for predictions, but something tells me we're going to see more than 16 points here.
You don't think we'll see 14 punts again?
I got to be honest, I hope not.
Yeah, I hope not, too. But just think about how things have changed a little bit. Gronk, who made one of the biggest plays in the Super Bowl down the stretch, no longer with the Patriots. And I don't think that the moment will be too big for the Rams going forward.
Steven Goskowski now has this one teed up, and we are underway from Gillette Stadium. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. They'll be led out by their quarterback, the guy out of California, the former Cal Bear, Jared Goff.
While in college, quarterback teams that improved their win total from 1 his freshman year, to 5 his sophomore year, to 8 his junior year. Love that type of improvement. Love that type of diligence.
Now the third leading rusher in the NFL last year, Todd Gurley. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. They go play action with Gurley. Now Goff. Airing it out deep for Woods. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Robert Woods, former USC man, the intended target, and it's 3rd and short. And quickly now, here's a look at the Rams offense.
And I think the entire league benefited when Andrew Whitworth made the decision to come back for his 13th NFL season. Still one of the best offensive tackles in the game. 4 Pro Bowls, 2 times first-team All-Pro. He's now 10th among active players in the NFL in games started.
An early test, 2 plays in. This is 3rd and 2. They'll try and pick up the first with Gurley. And I don't think Gurley got there. Looks like the defense held him back. The defense stiffens to force 4th down following that first down gain of 8. Strong start by this defense. 3rd and short, they go with a run. Stonewalled for no gain.
I played for a guy who always talked about setting tones and meeting force with force. That felt like it on that play, didn't it? And they met it in a big way and won. What a great job by the defense.
Now we see a man who got a workout in last year's Super Bowl, Johnny Hecker, on to punt for the Rams. Back deep for New England, Julian Edelman. On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Patriots come out led by the 4-time Super Bowl MVP and owner of a record 6 Super Bowl rings. Arguably the greatest to ever play the game, Tom Brady. And we keep asking the same questions every year. How much longer can he keep doing this? Is this the year the dynasty crumbles? And every year, Brady comes out and leads his team to the Super Bowl. They've been there now 3 years in a row, and only one team has made it 4. That's the Buffalo Bills. But remember, they lost all 4 in the early 90s. Brady and the Patriots now, 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line. They'll run with a former Super Bowl hero. It's James White. Gets this to the 24 for a gain of four. And now we take a peek at the Patriot offense.
And the big story, of course, no Rob Gronkowski at tight end. Who's going to step up for the big-time playmaker? Who's going to give Tom Brady the security blanket that he used to have from big number 87?
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Now the leading rusher for the Pats last year is a rookie, Sony Michel. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
So first and 10 now from the 30. On the ground, this is Michel. A big run there, 29 yards and a first. Couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 41. This is Michel on the counter. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. It's probably a pretty good sign here on the opening drive if your guys from the secondary are coming up and spilling things in the backfield.
How about the adrenaline and aggressiveness that led his eyes to the backfield to run up there and make that tackle, setting a tone early for his defense.
Wait, set. Wait, 20.
Hey, let's get that ball, D. Let's get that ball.
20, hit.
Now on second and 13. Brady, and he will find his man for the first time, Demaryius Thomas. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
Partney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot of fun. It's almost like you say, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go, and let's see who's faster.
Brady looking to throw on third and two. Trying to lay one up deep. And this is caught inside the five. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the five-yard line. It was third and short, and they go flying past the marker for a gain of nearly 30 yards. Big completion there on third and short keeps their opening drive alive.
Not only alive, but plenty of possibilities now. First and goal, and you know me, I'm a big advocate. If you're going to throw the ball, throw it early in the down and distance count.
Mike
58 right there. Watch the pass.
Hey, 66.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he keeps finding his way into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Pats have taken the early lead. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
Gostkowski with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. So that a 7-play, 80-yard drive. And it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. Gostkowski now after the touchdown. He'll send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that...